On the 92 Moose Morning Show, we were talking about bringing little kids to R-rated movies. I went to see Bad Moms on Saturday. Sitting right behind us were a couple with a little boy who could not have been more than 2 or 3 years old. And obviously, he got bored during the movie. He got up and was walking around right next to me a couple of times. To his credit, he wasn't overly loud, but it was uncomfortable. I felt bad for him. And it was uncomfortable for us having this little kid in an R-rated movie. Do you think little kids should be allowed to go to R-rated movies, even with adult supervision?
Well, we went on Saturday, too, and we went to the 9:30 viewing in Waterville. Mm-hmm. And there was a mom that walked in with probably her 6-year old with a doll and her blanket, and she was even making comments. I guess I'm a bad mom.
Yeah, I just don't understand. I mean, how are you enjoying the movie? I mean, I just say if you don't have a babysitter and you really want to go out and have a night out, I understand all of that, but is it really good for the kid to be hearing that
language? No, I get uncomfortable. It's like, even in weird movies at home, I'm like, my son's 11 almost.
Exactly. No, I know exactly how you feel, and I was. I was uncomfortable, not just for the kid, but for me.
Yeah.
You know, it's like,
I was like, this is odd.
Yeah. So did you like Bad Moms? I thought it was hilarious.
It was hilarious. We cried till we laughed so hard. It was just the medicine I needed.
It was very, very funny and very raunchy, but raunchy in a good way. It wasn't dirty.
Hilarious.
It wasn't dirty. I mean, it was an adult.
We all could find something to relate to, I think.
Absolutely. Yeah. Hey, I'm a bad mom too. So thanks for the call. Appreciate it.
Have a good day. We had gone to a mom's night. I think it was over a year ago. It was Neighbors. Mm-hmm. You remember that movie?
Oh, of course. Yep. Yeah, I never saw it, but I do remember it. Yep.
I mean, it was rated R for a reason. There was a lot of stuff in it. And we had gone to sit down, and we noticed right in back of us, there was an entire family that had come in with, like, babies and 2-year-olds and probably 4 or 5-year-olds.
Oh, wow.
I know. And I turned to them, and I said, hey, you know, this is an R-rated movie. And they said, mind your blank business.
Yeah,
and I'm thinking, well, it's just this age and the entitlement and whatever goes. And yeah, it's common sense.
Yeah, their response back to you says a lot. You know, says it.
Yeah, and the whole time I'm thinking, I couldn't even enjoy the movie.
Yep. Yeah, I was just going to say,
I can't believe that this 4-year-old is watching this.
Yeah, not only is it bad for the kids, it makes you uncomfortable. And you pay good money to go to a freaking movie these days.
Yeah.
You know, especially
absolutely.
At night with the popcorn and everything. My word.
Yeah. So, it was just an awful evening all around because the entire time. And they were so loud and so obnoxious.
Oh, see, that's
not the children, the parents.
Oh, really?
And
wow.
Yeah, it was just all the way around. And so I haven't really gone to the movie since then because it's just, I'd rather watch it with those that I love in my own house and not have to worry about
that's one
public.
One reason I like to go to the movies by myself. I actually went with my wife this time. I had to bring her with me. But no, I like going to the movies.
Nice.
I like going to the movies by myself early in the day.
Yeah.
When there's nobody else around. You know, that's...
Or if the movie's been out for a while.
Yeah, exactly. And you know there's not going to be a lot of people in the theater.
Yeah, 2:30, exactly. 2:30 on a Thursday afternoon.
Perfect.
There's like you and 3 other people.
Exactly. Yeah. Love that. All right. Thank you for the call.
Yeah. Have a great day.
Good morning, Nutty Tumos.
I have a weigh in on this.
Okay. On the movies? First, bringing toddlers to R-rated movies. What do you think?
Yes. Well, I've seen it twice. Mm-hmm. It was just so good.
You mean Bad Moms?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Bad Moms.
Very funny.
No, I would not allow. I have a 14-year-old, and I would not take him.
There
was nudity. There was nudity.
Was there? I don't even remember. See, that's. I honestly don't. I don't remember that. I remember the bad language. Yeah. What's that?
The computer.
The computer. Oh, that's right. That's right.
How could you forget?
That's right. Yes, there was. There was nudity. You're right. Well, a lot of it was covered up, if you know what I mean. But that's neither here nor there. You have to see the movie to understand
that. But it was there. So, yeah.
Yes, it was. You're right. I did forget about that.
Yeah, so no, I would
have
not.
2 young kids myself. Mm-hmm. I have a 2-year-old and a 4-year-old, and I think it's absolutely inappropriate.
Yeah, so you wouldn't bring them to an R-rated movie?
Absolutely not. In fact, me and my husband haven't been to a movie theater in about 2 years.
Yeah,
just for that purpose, because we can't afford having a babysitter either.
Right.
And it's very inappropriate because you can wait for it to come on DVD, wait for bedtime.
Exactly. And, it's only a few months away. It's like, you know.
Because I've been in that situation too, where like you're in a movie theater and there's another kid there. It's just there. It is very uncomfortable.
Yeah,
you know, being the other person that's not with kids. You know,
you have kids. You have to make some adjustments in your lifestyle. That's comes with the territory. You know,
exactly.
you still can't do everything you want to do.
Exactly.
You know?
And so I say absolutely not. In fact, maybe the movie theater should have a rule on how old.
Yeah, somebody mentioned that Regal has a 6 years old was the limit for R-rated movie. But still, that seems young to me.
I would say 13, probably.
I agree with you. That seems a little bit closer to what it should be. But I understand their point because as far as probably their national doesn't have rules. So they've got to figure it out. I don't know. I'm speaking out of turn here. But I absolutely agree with you. It seems like there should be some rules involved.
Yeah, I agree.
All right. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Okay, bye-bye.
Yeah, so I guess it would depend on why it's rated R.
Mm-hmm.
But definitely if it's scary, I would say no.
Yeah, no, this one was basically just the language. I mean, there was a little bit of sex, but nothing, you know, they weren't showing body parts or anything. But, I mean, it was just the language was very raw and raunchy. I mean, it was...
Yeah, I guess it would also depend, too, on, you know, respect to the rest of the audience. I mean, is the child going to be interrupting the movie, you know, talking?
This child, it wasn't like he was loud or anything, but you could tell he was bored. You know, I mean, he got up and was walking around a little bit. And,
yeah, I mean,
you know,
it's not like, the Secret Life of Pets.
Yeah, exactly. And I don't blame him for being bored. Why would he want to be there? You know,
right.
I know mom and dad want the night out, and I understand that. But... you know, you're parents now.
Right.
You got to deal with it. All right. Thanks for the call, buddy.
All right. Thank you.
Appreciate it. Bye.
My thought on the movie thing is if they're numb enough to bring the kids to a movie like that, what are they letting them watch at home?
Well, you know, you can't control that, unfortunately. But you can't. Well, the difference is it affects other people.
Yes.
I mean, what they're doing at home is going to affect other people down the road, obviously. But, you know, like a caller was saying, and I mentioned earlier, it makes us uncomfortable. You know,
it's
having this swearing, this raunchy stuff and sex and other stuff going on while this little kid is right next to you.
Yep.
You know, it just makes you so uncomfortable.
Yep. Well, that's because we didn't raise our kids that way.
Yeah, I guess that's it. All right. Appreciate it. Thank you.
All righty. Bye-bye.
Okay, bye. Good morning, Nutty Tumos.
Hi there. I just wanted to weigh in on the movie thing.
Sure. What do you think?
Well, I would not bring a toddler to a movie like that.
Mm-hmm.
And I've always actually been fortunate. My kids, there's a large age span in between them, and now they're 9 and 16. So if there's a movie that we really want to go see that is inappropriate for the kids, then we'll let my 16-year-old take my 9-year-old to the next movie theater just check in with them on their cell phone. And we'll watch the movie. Other than that, I would wait for it to come out on DVD.
Yeah, no, see, that sounds perfect. Yeah, somebody else mentioned earlier, well, why doesn't the mom just go to this movie and the dad take the toddler to an appropriate movie?
Right, exactly, because there was one movie that we didn't get a babysitter for, but there was a good movie coming out for kids, and they just went to the next theater, and we kept checking in on them with their cell phone, and we watched the movie, and then if we didn't hear from them, we got up and checked on them, and... it worked out perfect. If other than that, we would have waited for it to come out on DVD.
Yeah, no, that makes sense because for one thing, once a movie starts, you shouldn't be conversing and talking anyway. So
exactly. And you know, it makes you uncomfortable, and you're going to be chasing a toddler the whole time.
Yeah,
you're trying to watch the movie. So what's the point?
That perfectly said. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Have a great day. Bye bye.
You too. Bye bye.